Hi everyone, with Out Late But Great, it's Colette on Sunday coming at you with this week's topic from Michelle. And this week's topic is about the recent marriage equality being passed in Florida. And the question is, if you were married in a state that did recognize marriage equality, would you feel it necessary to get married again, yet again, or get married yet again in your home state? If so, why? Because of principle only? Does being legally recognized really change how you move through the world on a day-to-day basis? These are some really great questions. I do think that if you were married, maybe another state, and your state that you live in now recognize it, I mean, there's really no point. But if there's some laws that you don't know about that maybe you will be accessed to if you're married in that state, then maybe get married again. Personally, if I was in a gay relationship and we got married in another state and my state now recognized it, I probably would get married again just because it's like showing support for the state and it would be for principle only. But also, if you want to save money, then maybe not. So it's kind of up to you and your partner. And I do think that it does change how you move through the world on a day-to-day basis. There's a lot of stuff that you are now privy to when you're married that you weren't when before you got married. And now on paper, you're considered this legal partnership. And there's a lot of wonderful stuff that comes with that. In terms, I guess, you could think of it as a business. It's not really going to be, you're not going to get more love from it or something like that. But I think especially in terms of like Medicare and all that stuff, legal rights, property rights, which Maya touched on, there's a lot of stuff that will now fall in the hands of your partner, which could be a really good thing. Like for instance, like there's a few documentaries out there that I really recommend that you check out. One's called Edie and Thea's Very Long Engagement. And For My Wife by Charlene Strong. I'll put the links of information on them. They're really great documentaries because they really touch on what it's like on a legal standpoint if you're not really recognized for being married. And it really does open your eyes about how the institution of marriage is extremely discriminatory against LGBT people and how we deserve access to those things just like everyone else does. So I really highly recommend those. Also, if you're not married and you're single, I recommend making up your own will. So that way your family, if you're estranged from them, doesn't have the right to do that. Also, if you're concerned about how you're going to be taken care of when you pass away, that's another thing, because I've read some stories about some trans people that when they passed away, their family cut their hair to put them back in their male identity, even though they were female. And on their headstone, it's going to be their male name. So that is a huge thing. Like, even if you're not married and you have someone you trust or a couple people you trust, you can have them on there to be the person that takes care of that for you. Also, if you have health insurance, they do have a form, I believe, that you can fill out that if you're incapacitated for any reason, your partner or someone you trust can actually be the person that makes all the decisions. So those I think are highly important for you to do and consider, especially if you don't have a good relationship with your family and they don't understand you, they don't understand your relationship, they don't understand who you are. That's really important. And there's a great documentary talking about that, which is Southern Comfort, which is one of my all-time favorite documentaries. Because as a trans person, getting Medicare, even if you're not married or in a relationship, is terrifying because I mean, I'm lucky my insurance is very progressive, and I'm actually going to be a part of a survey group where they want to talk about how they can be more inclusive for trans people, which is amazing. But a lot of states and stuff, they don't want to help you. And if you're gay, they don't want to help you. And the scary part is all of us, you know, we're more younger and we have our health, and the scary part is when you get older and you have to go to an elderly facility or assisted living facility. And that's when it really pays to have, you know, someone that can look after you, even if your partner has passed away. Because I've heard some stories that, you know, some elderly facilities, they find out who you are, trans or gay, and they're very mean to you. And this is not to scare people, but it's just, you got to like kind of plan out some certain things and make sure that you're being taken care of, you know? And when you're married, kind of the plus about that is that's kind of like a little built-in insurance for a while. So I hope I'm making sense about this topic, but I do think it does change how you move through the world, even on a subtle scale to a giant scale. And I think that the cool thing is, on paper, legally recognized, you are this new partnership. And I think that that is a wonderful and fabulous thing. And I also think that if you're a couple that you have no desire to get married, it's not kind of in your peripheral, then that's fabulous too, you know? And for me, marriage is more or less combining two homes into one on a legal standpoint. It's not necessarily about love. I mean, it is, because you're committing to each other, but it's kind of a business transaction. Like, for instance, my boyfriend and I aren't married or anything. We talk about it, though, like, in the future. It's not something, I guess, that I've done a lot of wedding makeup, so I've been around a lot of weddings, and I think they're fabulous and fun. But I guess, like, for me, like, when we get married, it probably will just be, I don't know, kind of just solidifying. I already kind of feel like I am married, I guess you could say. But legally, I do kind of want it just for, you know, the rights and all that good stuff. And I want, you know, but I just try to make sure that legally he takes care of everything if something happens to me. But yeah, I do think it does change. It changes a lot. And even just mentally, it changes, I think, kind of how you perceive, like, you're married now. And I think it's a good thing. So I'm a Libra, so we're all about marriage. Okay, well, that's this week's topic. I'm going to go ahead and sign off for the day. And I will check in with you guys next week. All right, bye.